about to give up. She told me this story. She was about to give up, but she found the strength to keep going on. And now, after being a finalist of America's Got Talent and performing all over the world as a singer, is that not the most awesome thing? To give up for
She's very pretty. I can't wait to talk to her. I hope I do. I know sign language.
I'm really excited to be a part of today, and I've been tackled so many different beautiful things and projects you guys are working on. And if you follow me at all, you understand I have such a heart to give to others, and I'm so proud of all the hard work that you guys are doing and all the work that you are to spread love around. It's so important, so you should be really proud of yourselves, because I'm super proud of you. And I'm excited to be here! Woohoo! I wanted to talk just a little bit and then sing a couple songs if that's okay. I started with music when I was about 4 years old. When I was growing up, I was hard of hearing, and I was always scared to be a part of conversations because I misunderstood all the time. So I was that shy, nervous child who didn't have friends and didn't talk to other people. And then getting involved with choir was my way to express myself and my way to be a part of the team. And the instant friendship and work that is there when you're working in choir, working as part to make something so beautiful. I was also that one that would hate and was terrified to sing by myself. I don't know if you were that person. First time I ever had to sing for an audition, I vomited on everyone. Wow. The second time I cried and passed out, so woo! Stage fright was a huge one for me. But I went to school, I really wanted to do vocal music education because I was inspired by my teachers, and I got there. And when I was there, after about a month of being there, I couldn't understand my teachers talking anymore. And I thought, maybe I had an ear infection. And it got worse, and it got worse, and it got worse. And eventually I couldn't understand anybody talking at all. And I was dropped from the music program. And what happened, and my biggest mistake, was that I identified my entire self with one dream. And that's a mistake. I thought that if I couldn't have music the way that I thought it should go, my career had to be the way that I thought it should go, then it wasn't worth it. And that is not true, because you are made up of thousands of dreams, thousands of ways to express yourself. And music is a part of the soul. It doesn't disappear just because you can't hear. It doesn't disappear just because you experience it differently. You have an opportunity to expand your horizons and dive into music in a different way that you've never even thought of. So now, without being able to hear, I get to feel music. It's an opportunity you all have. I would encourage you guys to kick off your shoes at some point and put on the music and feel it through the floor. But I had to start my way through experiencing it in a different world. And I fell in love with it even more. And I appreciate music even more. And I appreciate choir even more, even without being able to hear. Because like I said, music is a part of the soul, and it needs to be shared. So I've been encouraged and pushed by all these different people all across the world, and I found myself on a giantly weird stage of America's Got Talent, which was terrifying, but I was there. And I sang this next song, and I wanted to sing it for you. I wrote because I was approached by a friend of mine who said, why are you not writing your own music? Why are you not sharing your story? I said, it's because I'm afraid. And he said, what's the worst that could happen? Growing up, my biggest fear was always losing my hearing. And it happened. And I survived. If not, I feel like I'm a better person. So what can singing in front of a bunch of people do to me? Not much. My biggest fear already happened. So if I write a song and express myself, awesome. If someone doesn't like it, who cares? At least I'm expressing myself. So this song is about saying, you know what? I don't know necessarily what my plan is or what it's gonna look like tomorrow, but I have music in my soul and I need to get out of my own way and stop telling myself that I can't. That's what that's about.
22.
Sky.